We've got our hands on this compact, budget-friendly Chinese motherboard, and right off the bat, it gives off similar vibes to the Maxon P650 we reviewed earlier. The best part, it's fully compatible with powerful AMD Ryzen 9800X 3D CPU. Now, when I work with motherboards like this, I often dig through datasheets, manuals, and BIOS PDFs. And that's where today's sponsor, SwiftDo PDF Editor, comes in handy. It's a lightweight yet powerful tool that covers all your PDF needs. Edit, convert, merge, split, organize, sign and annotate, even recognize text from scanned documents. What really sets it apart is the built-in AI PDF assistant powered by ChatGPT-4. You can chat with your PDFs, summarize long documents, translate, explain, rewrite, and proofread content in seconds. It's the ultimate PDF companion for tech enthusiasts, students, and professionals alike. Right after opening the box, you'll find the motherboard securely packed inside an anti-static bag. I ordered the white version, and thanks to its compact size, it fits perfectly in almost any case, including mini ITX builds. Inside the box, you get a user manual in Chinese, two SATA cables, and a standard I/O shield. One standout feature of this little board is its passive VRM heatsink, capable of delivering up to 150 watts. The main M.2 NVMe slot comes with a heatsink pre-installed, and there's a second M.2 slot on the back for additional storage. You also get an M.2 key slot for Wi-Fi modules, so you can easily add wireless connectivity using external antennas. All standard headers and connectors are included, with color-coded pins for easy installation. There are also two 5-volt 3-pin ARGB headers for RGB lighting. The PCI Express 16 slot for your GPU feels solid, and the rear I/O panel features a USB Type-C port that also supports high-quality audio output, plus a handy BIOS reset button is there. This board is an easy fit for most ITX cases, but when building a mini PC, make sure you have a compatible small form factor PSU and low profile CPU cooler. Always double check compatibility before starting your build. The Onda B650 Plus ITX supports a wide range of AM5 CPUs, including powerful options like the Ryzen 9 9800X and 9950X3D. Just make sure to check for the latest CPU support BIOS updates on the official website. In terms of memory, this board supports up to 96 gigs of DDR5 RAM, with speeds ranging from 4800 to 6000 MHz using Expo overclocking profiles. Alright, let's install the M.2 NVMe SSD. First, remove the heatsink and don't forget to peel off the protective sticker before placing it back. Otherwise, you might run into thermal issues or serious overheating problems. Installing the AM5 Ryzen CPU is straightforward. Just match the notch on the CPU with the socket. Gently drop it in and secure it by lowering the retention lever. Installing an AM5 compatible cooler and RAM is also simple. No rocket science here. But if you like a dedicated step-by-step tutorial on installing AM5 CPUs and coolers, let me know in the comments and make sure to subscribe. The BIOS UI on the Onda B650 Plus ITX looks almost identical to what we saw on the Maxon B650 Wi-Fi motherboard. Be sure to check out that video on our channel if you haven't already. Now let's walk through some essential BIOS settings. Starting with how to increase shared graphics memory, go to Advanced, then AMD CBS, then NBIO Common Options. From there, go to Graphics Configuration, set iGPU configuration to UMA specified, then increase the video memory from the UMA frame buffer size option. To enable virtualization, head to Advanced PCI Subsystem Settings and enable SRIOV support. For overclocking, you'll find the AMD Expo profiles, CPU, iGPU, SoC, and voltage tweaks all under the Advanced tab. There's also a dedicated memory overclocking tab right at the top for tuning your RAM speeds. There are plenty of other advanced features on this motherboard, So that's everything. A compact, sleek, all-white D650 ITX board packed with BIOS options you normally only find on higher-end motherboards. If you're building a small budget-friendly system, this one's worth checking out. Just keep it in mind, it's available mostly in Asian markets. Hit like if this helped you and subscribe for more tutorials and reviews.